Hello, hello, and welcome to the Borealis Experience. I'm your host, Aurora, and I'm very happy to be spending some time with you today. Episode 1 of Season 6. Wow, I'm so excited to be launching this new season. Every season has, its own touch. And let's see what the season is going to be about and how it's going to serve you, help you heal, recover, let go, move on. Yes, all of the above. I want to create a space for you where you can rest and recharge your batteries and reconnect to yourself and be a stronger, more resilient individual, a person that is driven by love and compassion, with an open mind and open heart, men and women, all together in this. And I must say, my main focus is actually to better the relationship between men and women and to address the tensions that I can feel in society right now. Today I want to talk about how you can heal your relationship to women. And you don't necessarily have to be a man who was heartbroken, like disappointed by a woman once. You can be a girl who was hurt by girlfriends or disappointed by their mom or grandma. It doesn't actually matter which gender you are, how you identify, because we have both energies within us, and bear with me, I'm not going to get too spiritual, but this is for me the easiest way to describe it. There is a driven force, a force that longs for structure, that pushes forward, roaming within us. And then there is a force that is very nurturing and receptive, intuitive. And I just like to describe or to label these energies as masculine and feminine. And again, it doesn't matter in which body you were born, we have both energies and lots of more energies roaming inside of us, but those two energies is what I want to talk about today. So you will see women in society who are very driven, very heady, very, elbowy. They are, sometimes even aggressive. Is it active aggression or passive aggression? And these women, I want to say, have learned that they have to adapt to the masculine in order to survive in society, in order to get shit done. But those women aren't necessarily happier than other women who choose to stay in their feminine and choose to live a life of nurturing and receiving and creating. And now, don't get me wrong, these power-driven people also get lots done. But I want to talk about the people who are out of balance, who neglect their feminine side. And I pulled out this first example because it happens in both, in men and in women. And more we drift into this masculine energy where we're only pushing forwards and we're proud of being exhausted. We're proud of hitting burnout. We're proud of achieving and accomplishing so much. And to be emotional, to be intuitive, to be quiet is not as valued as you would think it is. When we feel our emotions, when we have our mood swings, especially us women who are on their natural cycle, we see that as inconvenience. And same goes for men. When men are reacting in an emotional way, when men are expressing themselves like on a more feely level, we see it as a weakness instead of strength. And there is a beautiful shift happening right now, and I just want to keep pushing for that beautiful shift, because I feel it is very important for all of us to come back to our intuition and to feel what is right and to learn to distinguish what is not so good for us and what is good for us. And that is what your intuitive side is here for. Now, when we want to talk about how to heal your relationship with women, it's not a surprise for you, maybe, if you've listened to my podcast for a little while now. It starts with you. Now, how does it start with you? Because those women are outside of yourself. They might be even not really in your life at the moment because you still resent them. You cut them out of your life and you don't want nothing to do with them. But what I mean by when I say it starts with you is that you have to start to forgive yourself. You have to start and sit with your emotions when you feel something. Nobody else is going to do it for you. You have to do it for yourself. Because if you live a life of constant masculinity, you know, pushy energy, chances are that your relationships with women, with really feminine women, is difficult as well, because you're not going to accept their femininity if they start expressing themselves, if they start to be intuitive, sensitive, you know, very sensual. You will want to abuse that. You will want to suppress it because it is something that you're not allowing in yourself. So how can we become more at peace with our feminine energy? I think we just have to learn and take ourselves more seriously. And what I mean by that is that we look at ourselves and start accepting all parts. We stop rejecting ourselves when we look into the mirror, for instance, or when we feel emotions come up and it's an inconvenient point in life. We start accepting that life is like the ocean, you know, it comes and goes, there's tidal waves, there's the tide, there is all kinds of movements and change and adaptation. Life is a flow and not a stagnant pond. You know, life is like clouds, like a river. It floats by and changes. It's never the same from one second to the other. There's always change happening. And the feminine energy is very moody and changes, and that's why it also needs the masculine to keep each other in check. And this is what I emphasize in my podcast, in my videos, is that we need each other. Of course, you can't all of a sudden become these super emotional, intuitive, mood swingy personality. You need to keep yourself in check. But I feel most of us, we keep ourselves too much in check. And we don't allow playfulness, intuition, feelings to arise. We don't like this. We want to function. We want to be productive. We want to be effective. But it comes with a cost. Your soul will become sick of that if you take it too much to an extreme. You see, when I have my personal training clients or my coaching clients, I often realize that they're a little bit stuck in the accomplishment, goal-driven energy. And I just need to pull them a little bit further to the self-care corner, to the corner where we allow flowing in movement, in thoughts, in perception, and playfulness. And most of the time, if not all of the time, those people are being helped a lot already. Yeah. So once you learn to accept yourself and embrace all the little bits that back in the day you would have seen as failures, you are making peace with your internal feminine. And in doing so, you will heal your relationships with the women in your life. Now, of course, if the women in your life are very heady and masculine driven, it will be tough because now all of a sudden you're going to be challenging them. But that challenge is a good one for them, I believe, because it's going to inspire them to go a similar path. And when I say making peace with the women in your life, I don't mean that you might get back with your ex or completely heal your relationships with them, because it is still their choice and their decision. But for yourself, for your own sake, you will find peace in your chest, within yourself. Yeah, I think that was it for today. I was at war with my feminine for the longest time. Many of you know that I was raped when I was in my 20s, and after that, I excessively worked out. I was, yeah, in relationships with men, but always managed to manipulate myself out, to not really show up as myself, because I was hurt back then. I was abused and I was now scared and felt I had to defend myself all of the time. And that thinking turned me into this more than necessary masculine woman. And it kept driving my partners away instead of towards me. And once I've learned to embrace my feminine side again, my sensitive side, and to be vulnerable again, to respect my intuition, to allow feelings to come up, to know that I don't have to be strong all the time. I can be soft and playful. That was the time when I started healing. And I not only started healing from the inside, but I healed my relationships with my girlfriends, And with the men in my life, my dad, my brother, my guy friends. And I was then able to start a beautiful, nurturing relationship with my boyfriend I have today. So it is a really valuable journey to address and to be on, because it's going to make your life so much easier in the end. It will be tough at times to be vulnerable again and to be sensitive and to show up as your true self. Don't get me wrong. It's a lot of time you're like, oh my God, what is this shit show? I thought it was an easy path to surrender and to heal, but it is not. But it is so worth it. So I hope I was able to deliver this episode in a way that it was easy to understand and brought lots of, value to your life. Maybe a little bit of a new perspective on healing and approaching self-care. I would love to hear your comments. I would love to hear what you think and where are you at on your journey to recovery and healing your relationship with women. Thank you so much for listening. I appreciate you so much. And I'm very excited to be with you on this journey. If ever you feel the need to, talk to me personally and to have someone hear you out and ask for advice or have a different perspective given, then never hesitate to contact me and we'll have a 60-minute coach call, which is entirely free. The first session is on me and I bow down to your courage and your willingness to change and to look at yourself and see what potential is in there that we together can bring out. All right, until next time.